All right. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your patience. Here we go. Stamp Fairtex joins us in the wake of a split decision win over Supergirl. Always good to see you, Stamp. Wanted to know, with your very strong background in Muay Thai, how does that influence the way you fight in kickboxing?
รู้ว่าต้องเตะต่อยแบบไหนค่ะแค่นั้นเลยแต่ว่ามวยไทยมันแค่ไม่มีศอกแล้วก็จับขาแล้วก็เข่าไม่ได้มันเลยเป็นการเขาเรียกว่าอะไรอ่ะเหมือนจะได้เปรียบแล้วก็เหมือนจะเสียเปรียบเพราะว่าแอนนาไม่สามารถที่จะศอกหรือเข่าหนูได้เพราะว่าน้องแบบยาวกว่าหนูแล้วก็ได้เปรียบมากกว่าหนู
It's both advantage and also disadvantage. My background in Muay Thai, I know how to punch and also throw a kick, but also in kickboxing, I cannot use elbows or knees. It's an advantage for me because Anna is taller than me and he cannot use knees or elbows against me. So like, it's kind of two ways.
Media from around the world, you can raise your hand if you want to ask a question or ask a question using the chat box. Our first question comes from Aaron East of MMA UK News. Go ahead, Aaron.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Hi, well, congratulations on an absolutely outstanding performance. I just have one question for you. But was there any part of the bout that you felt a little bit pressured? I mean, you were smiling the whole way through. It was amazing to see, but in the first round, did you feel any sort of pressure?
ค่ะจริงๆหนูกดดันค่ะต่อยไฟนี้เพราะว่าเราเสียเปรียบรูปร่างด้วยแล้วก็เสียเปรียบน้ำหนักด้วยค่ะหนูคิดกับตัวเองว่ามันกดดันในทางนึงแล้วก็คิดกับตัวเองว่าให้ตัวเองต่อยให้สนุกที่สุดแพ้ชนะค่อยว่ากันทีหลัง
Yes, it was a lot of pressure for me because I have got a few disadvantages in terms of physique and also weight class. But I think to myself that I would just do this as I would just have fun. And this will be like an entertainment, like losing or winning, it doesn't matter.
You definitely you had fun out there. Thank you ever so much for taking my question.
Cheers, Aaron. Our next question comes from Jeffrey Hu of Kung Fu Kingdom.
Hello, Stamp, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so how were you able to like deal with like say the pressure of Supergirl? And also are you actually planning on like making the move back to kickboxing now that you've called out Janet Todd and Alicia?
ยกแรกหนูกดดันค่ะเพราะว่าหนูไม่รู้ว่าหนูจะต้องต่อยแบบไหนในยกแรกซึ่งหนูเหมือนดูเกมยกแรกอะค่ะว่าเราจะต้องออกรูปแบบไหนมันก็เลยจะแบบเก่งๆกลางๆไม่ค่อยถนัดสักเท่าไหร่แล้วสุดท้ายแล้วที่หนูขอเอาอาริเซียกับเจเน็ตคอร์ดเพราะว่าหนูอยากจะชกชิงแชมป์คิกบ็อกซิ่งแล้วก็มวยไทยค่ะ
Okay, the first round was a bit difficult for me. I used the first round to just looking at the game and also like looking how to like plan out the strategy. For the second question, yes, I called out Alicia and Janet Todd because I want to win the belt for kickboxing and Muay Thai.
Okay, thank you. And one last question. It's very unfortunate that Anixa Mexen, was it? Yeah, that she did not show up to a weigh-in and the mixed rules fight had to be canceled. Are you still looking forward to that fight?
จริงๆหนูไม่ค่อยอยากชกอนิสาเท่าไหร่ค่ะเพราะว่าเป็นเขาเรียกว่าอะไรไม่เป็นมืออาชีพซึ่งหนูก็ไม่ได้อยากชกกับคนที่ไม่เป็นมืออาชีพสักเท่าไหร่ค่ะเพราะมันจะทำให้หนูเดือดร้อนเหมือนไฟนี้ค่ะหนูต้องหาผู้ต่อยหลายคนมากเลยกว่าจะลงเอยมาเป็นน้องแอนนาค่ะ
I am not really looking forward to fight with Anissa because I consider this unprofessional. I was like I spent a lot of time looking for a new opponent in this event, so like I don't really look forward to that again.
Okay, ขอบคุณครับ
Thank you.
Our next question comes in via text from Luisa Morales from Philstar, who asks, you just had an exciting match in front of your home country fans, but how would you feel about fighting on one's first US card? Does that excite you?
หนูตื่นเต้นทุกไฟค่ะเพราะว่าหนูรู้สึกว่ากดดันทุกไฟแล้วแต่ละไฟของหนูมันเป็นไฟที่ใหญ่มากๆค่ะมันเลยทำให้หนูตื่นเต้นก่อนต่อยทุกครั้งค่ะ
Actually I am excitedwith every fight that I have fought before, and every fight is considered very big to me. Yeah, there's always excitement for me.
Our next question comes from Abdullah from Verdict MMA. Abdullah, go ahead.
Hello, Stamp.
Yes.
You have a lot of time left in your career if you still wish to continue fighting. Is it more important to you to reclaim titles in kickboxing and Muay Thai, or do you want to prove you can be champion in MMA?
ณตอนนี้หนูคิดว่าสำหรับแองเจล่าลียังสะเทือนใจกับสิ่งที่เกิดขึ้นอยู่ในปลายเดือนที่ผ่านมาหนูเลยอยากจะใช้เวลาตรงนี้ไปเอาเข็มขัดมวยไทยและคิกบ็อกซิ่งก่อนค่ะแล้วค่อยกลับไปหาแองเจล่าลีค่ะ
I would like to use this time to reclaim my title in kickboxing and Muay Thai because I still feel sad about what happened with Angela Lee and Lee family. So that will take a while, and after a while, I'll go back to MMA for Angela Lee.
Thank you very much. Congratulations tonight.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from Stephen from Violent Money TV. Go ahead, Stephen.
Sorry, I had an issue with my mic. I'm sorry. Hi, Stamp. Congratulations on the win. In addition to your incredible fighting skills, the one thing people love to see in a Stamp fight is the walkout. Today, you chose Jessie and Nuni Nana. Talk to me about the decision to choose this song.
No, I love Jessie. I love Jessie. Because Jessie is sexy. Hot. And then...ค่ะหนูเลือกเพลงนี้เพราะว่ารู้สึกว่าหนูถูกชะตากับเพลงนี้ค่ะแล้วก็ชอบเพลงนี้ที่ก็เลยเลือกเอามาเต้นค่ะ
I love this this song and I love Jessie she is so sexy and she's really hot so that's why I chose this song and it just like it just feel right for me right now
Thank you Sam congratulations on the win
Thank you
Sam $50,000 in the bank for you what's the first thing you're going to go out and buy
หนูยังไม่รู้ค่ะเพราะว่าหนูไม่คิดหนูจะได้โบนัสเหมือนกันก็ยังไม่มีแผนค่ะแต่ก็กุมเงินไว้ก่อนค่ะ
I don't have any plan yet because I did not think that I would get it so I'll think about that later
Stamp Fairtex maximum respect always a pleasure thank you
thank you
Can I have your thoughts on the open weight Grand Prix what do you think about the tournament and who do you want to face
ถ้าผมได้ลงในรูปแบบมวยไทยผมก็ต้องผ่านทุกคนไม่ได้ครับเพื่อที่จะคว้ารางวัลที่สูงมูลค่ามากครับ
I have of course I have to fight every opponent that I have been matched with in order to get the big prize
We go across to our media questions now First in is Aaron East of MMA UK News Go ahead Aaron
Thank you Well, congratulations. Another absolutely outstanding victory by yourself. I know you said in the circle that you were looking at the main event, but I think the whole world would like to know, would the MMA rule set would be part of your future in 2023?
ก็ผมก็อยากไปทีละขั้นนะเพราะว่าผมอยากเป็นแชมป์คิกบ็อกซิ่งก่อนแล้วก็ค่อยผันตัวเองไป MMA ครับผม
I want to go step by step. I want to claim my title in kickboxing first, and then I will go to MMA.
Thank you. I wish you all the best for your kickboxing aspirations, and I hope to see you on the MMA rule set. Take care. Thank you.
Cheers, Aaron. Next question comes from Jeffrey Hu from Kung Fu Kingdom.
Hello. Sawadee kap, Rodtang. So, It's another dominant performance, and congratulations, first of all. And so, do you really think that it would be fair for your next kickboxing fight to be for the flyweight title?
แน่นอนครับรุ่น flyweight แน่นอนผมต้องไปถึงแชมป์ไม่ได้ครับ
Of course, I will participate in flyweight, and I will claim my title.
Okay, thank you, Rodtang. I do look forward to it.
Thank you.
Kyle Siegel has our next question with the Going Live Network. Go ahead, Kyle.
Hey, Rodtang. This is Kyle with the Going Live Network. We're giant fans in the States. love what you do. Now, fighting all these opponents that seems like they're just giving you almost cattle, you know, for you to just knock out or get unanimous decisions. I guess at what point do you think you're going to take that next step? And do you want to move in weight? Do you want to, you know, fight two different divisions? Like, what's your next goal?
เปลี่ยนเวทขยับเวทครับแน่นะครับก็ไม่แน่ครับแต่ก็ผมยังไหวอยู่ในเวทรุ่นไฟเวทนี่ผมก็อยากไปถึงเข็มขัด Kickboxing อีกเส้นหนึ่งแล้วก็ผันตัวเองไป MMA อีกรอบนะครับ
My goal is right now to stay in flyweight division and claim the kickboxing title and then I will move to MMA.
Awesome. And in the States, do you realize how popular you are in terms of like you're the best, you know, kickboxer out there?
ผมต้องขอบคุณทุกคนที่คิดว่าผมเก่งเป็นที่หนึ่งบ้างนะครับ ผมคิดว่าผมแค่เป็นนักมวยธรรมดาคนหนึ่งครับ ที่แค่สู้เพื่อเอาชัยชนะในแต่ละไฟครับ ผมแค่คิดแค่นี้เองครับ ผมไม่รู้ว่าตัวเองจะเก่งขนาดไหน ผมไม่คิดตรงนั้นครับ เพราะว่าผมแค่อยากทำในแต่ละไฟให้มันดีที่สุด ทำในแต่ละไฟให้มันชนะให้ได้ที่สุดครับผม
Actually, consider myself just a normal fighter. I would like to thank everyone for considering me one of the best fighter or like the best one out there. I just want to do the best I can in every fight.
Thank you, Rodtang. We absolutely love watching your fights.
Thank you.
Our next question comes in via text from Luisa Morales from Philstar, who asks, do you think you're ready to face the winner of Superlek and Puertas?
แน่นอนครับ ผมพร้อมแน่นอนครับ รอดูว่าใครจะเป็นแชมป์แล้วเจอกันครับ
Absolutely, I am ready. So let's see who's winning and we'll see you there.
Can you talk us through the fight, Rodtang? You look so fresh. You look like you're able to go several more rounds if you wanted to. What's your secret?
My secret is my heart is a real fighter. I'm a real fighter in my heart and I go 100% every round.
Well, I hope everyone around the world knows by now when Rodtang fights, you watch. Incredible stuff as ever. Absolute fireworks, sir. Thank you very much. Okay. What was going through your head when Gantama's foot was basically backwards, but he didn't tap?
I'm kind of nauseous right now. You know, I'm really sick to my stomach. I never felt someone's leg explode like that in a match. You know, been training 22 years. I never broke someone's leg that much. I've broken a lot of legs, but the amount that leg exploded, I didn't know what to do. And like, it was just disgusting and gross. I really wish he tapped. The result didn't change and now he's in hospital. So I don't know. But what a warrior he is for showing his will.
Wow. All right, we're going to go across to Aaron East now from MMA UK News.
Mikey, congratulations once again.
Thank you, sir.
Very welcome. What do you feel like this, what tonight was one of your toughest tests to date?
Definitely the most nauseous I've been after a match from the match, but it was interesting. Sometimes I have this problem when I fight where I get too stubborn on a submission or I focus on something and then to channel, to change, to do something else. So the problem was I kept popping his leg. So I felt like, how do I stop doing this move if it keeps popping? So eventually I was like, screw it. I looked at my corner. There are like 2 minutes left. And I'm like, screw it. I let go. And then I took his back. I should have probably done that earlier. But how do I let go again if I keep doing damage to a certain limb? I definitely have never been in that exact scenario. So it was new for me, for sure.
It was a little unpleasant to watch also.
Yeah, and, I don't even want to watch the match.
I don't blame you. There was one last question. You've achieved so much under the one banner. Is there anyone specifically on the roster or a dream match for yourself that you'd like to face on the mats?
Yeah. So definitely Mighty Mouse in the future and hopefully on a US card. I also would like to fight Adrian Moraes on a Brazil card for one. I know one's going to have their Brazil event. I know he's down the road with me. So it would be awesome. We could go in the circle for one's first event in Brazil. I'm sure he would love that too. And I speak Portuguese and I have a lot of Brazilian followers, so it would be great for the Brazilian fans.
I'll definitely look out for them. Thank you ever so much for taking my questions and congratulations once again.
Thank you so much, sir. Have a nice day.
You too. Thank you.
Onward now to Jeffrey Hu from Kung Fu Kingdom.
Hello, Mikey. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. How you doing?
I'm great. How about you?
I'm good. I'm just upset I didn't get the submission win, but it is what it is.
Most definitely. So first of all, congrats on your win.
Thank you.
So as for the Adriano Moraes matchup, that is in submission grappling, correct?
Yes, sir. He's a black belt in jiu-jitsu also, and he actually requested to have a match with me, so multiple times. So I think we should just do it in Brazil. One is going to have their first card in Brazil this year, and I'm fluent in Portuguese, and I have a lot of Brazilian followers also, so it would be great for the Brazilian crowd.
Great. I definitely look forward to that. Do you have like any other opponents in mind whom you want to defend your title against?
Yes. There's this guy that just won Nogi Black Belt Worlds in my division named Osama. He's the first Black Belt World Champion from the Middle East. He lives in San Diego, trains at Gaval in Atos. I feel like we would have a great match together, the current Nogi World Champion versus me. I feel like that would just make sense, right? So possibly that would be my next match. But again, there's so many tough guys, whoever they want me to face, I'm here.
I definitely look forward to that matchup as well. And do you have like any plans on like transitioning into MMA soon or?
Soon, I wouldn't say soon. I train at Evolve. So I have the best Muay Thai program in the world. So I plan on learning Muay Thai the next year or so and then seeing where my level goes. And I did Muay Thai like 7 years as a kid. So I have a background in Muay Thai. I just have to learn again, but it's not like I haven't done any martial arts like stand up, you know? So I would just like to see how I progress over time. And then I would love to see if I would like to do MMA.
Definitely looking forward to that. And thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Next question comes from Kyle Segal from the Going Live Network. Go ahead, Kyle.
Hey, Mikey, congrats on another dominant victory. I love seeing you. It's like you get better every single match.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Of course. Do you think there's a super fight on the horizon between you and Cade Rotolo?
Cade's like two weight classes above me. He's 170. I'm 135. So I just really want to focus on my division right now. I don't really plan on going up in weight. I plan
no
on
competing. Problem. I just had to ask because you both are top of the food chain. So
I plan on being like another like 15 years. So I need my body healthy. By doing heavier divisions, I'll probably have to stop competing a lot sooner because it'll be too much impact, you know?
Of course, Mikey. Congrats again on the victory.
Thank you so much, sir.
No problem.
We have a question via text from Andrew Mack of MMA Ireland, who asks, we often hear that you can't feel bad for your opponent, but we're all concerned for Gantamer's health after several minutes of destroying his knee. I think that you touched upon this a little bit earlier, but it was pretty concerning, right?
Yeah, I just think it was just no point. Like, he lost anyway. Like, for example, if you're winning a match, like in IBJJF, where there's points, and you're in a submission, like you tough it out, you might pop your foot or something, but you win the match. But if you're completely losing a match, and you're in a full-out submission, just not tapping, you're just going to injure yourself. And when I compete, I don't want to hurt anyone. I want them to train tomorrow, you know? I just want to, I don't want to hurt my opponent at all. So I really didn't like being put in that position that I had to break his leg, you know? And I'm like nauseous right now from doing it. I'm a really gentle training partner. Like, I don't hurt anyone I roll with, you know? So it definitely had to pull out a part of me that like I didn't like. It just was stupid. I just thought it was a waste of him doing that to his leg. I don't know.
Our last question comes from Andrea Tang from Jiu-Jitsu Times. Go ahead, Andrea.
Hi, can you hear me, Mikey?
Yes. Hey, Adrian.
Hey, good getting to catch up with you again. Congratulations on your win. Incredible performance, as always. I know that you are disappointed that you didn't get the tap, and as you've articulated so well, like it's just
weird because it's the most I popped someone's leg in my life, but I didn't get a tap from it. So I feel
right. So which was bizarre to watch unfold as well, as someone who's seen a lot of grappling. But, and I know, like you touched on that earlier, that like, it really sucks being put in that position, where you have to hurt someone. But like, I know that hindsight is 20/20, but if you could kind of turn back time and like do this match over again, like knowing what you know about
just choke him, just put him to sleep.
Yeah. That's what you would do differently.
Yeah. I looked at my corner. I heard them say 2 minutes and then I just let go of the submission. And then I almost calf sliced him, I think.
We saw the cast.
And then I took his back, and I should have just done that from the beginning. Like I could have definitely just put him to sleep. But like, I don't know. How do I shut off my mind from doing a submission when it's like popping someone's limb? You know what I mean? Like I wasn't being stubborn this time. Like it actually was popping. Like if it wasn't popping and it like, okay, but like I felt it keep breaking. So like, I feel like I wasn't being as stubborn as I usually am, but it still didn't do it enough. I don't know.
Yeah, I know. Really, really shocking on his part. But I mean, kudos to you also.
And he's a tough, and what a tough opponent, right? What a warrior he is for breaking his leg for no reason.
Oh gosh, that's certainly one way of looking at it. But yeah, congratulations again. Looking forward to seeing your next match.
Thank you so much.
Absolute wizard, Mikey. Thank you for joining us. Always a pleasure. Cheers.
Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Demetrious Johnson. What's up, Demetrious? Good to see you. First off, how excited are you to take the show on the road and go to the United States?
I'm super excited. Obviously, I've started my career in, the United States of America, and be able to come back to it this late in my career is amazing. So I'm very happy for the fans and the fans over in America to be able to get the opportunity to see me fight, once again.
Abdullah is with us from Verdict MMA. Abdullah, go ahead with your question.
Hey, Demetrious. You'll be fighting on home soil for the first time in a long time. Is that a better feeling than fighting abroad, or do you prefer that you get to travel the world as a part of your job?
It goes both ways, right? I do enjoy fighting on home soil just because not a big time zone change, not long flights. And I actually also do enjoy traveling around the world, competing as a foreigner in the beautiful world, beautiful country of Asia.
Thanks. For me, what sets you apart from others in the, quote unquote, greatest of all time conversation is the fact that you never stopped improving. You never relaxed and decided to stop growing. Obviously excluding the early days when a fighter is absorbing knowledge like a sponge, in what phase of your career do you feel like you improved most and why?
That's an interesting question. I think to answer that is I feel like in my whole entire career, I've always been growing and just understanding my style and how is the best way for me to implement it, depending on the opponent I'm fighting. And obviously now people are seeing it more because I battled adversity when I fought Adriano Moraes the first time, and then taking that fight against Rodtang, absolutely amazing fighter, doing one round Muay Thai, second round MMA, and then coming out victorious in that one, then going and fighting Adriano Moraes for the second time. A lot of athletes, when they suffer a huge defeat and get knocked out, they get kind of gun shy. But for me, I think just my overall growth as a mixed martial artist and just getting better probably separates me different from the other, people who on the list of the greatest of all time.
Love the answer. Thank you so much. Can't wait to have you back in America.
Hey.
Next question is Jeffrey Hu from Kung Fu Kingdom. Go ahead, Jeffrey.
Go ahead, Jeffrey.
Can we open the mic for Jeffrey, please?
Jeffrey, you got to stop playing Galaga.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Good. Hey, Jeffrey. Hey.
Yeah, I thought they unmuted for me. My bad. As for your matchup with Adriano Moraes, what kind of adjustments do you think he's going to make, and how are you going to prepare yourself for those adjustments?
Yeah, I think the adjustment he's going to make, he's going to go back and watch the second fight and see where I was able to, where I was beating him at, I guess you can say. And then for me, I'm just going to train. I'm just going to go out there and try to be the best Demetrious Johnson I can be. You know, when we looked at the first fight against him, we saw, you know, a lot of things, and then we were able to, you know, execute on it on the second fight. And in the third fight, I plan on doing the exact same thing, just being in better shape, faster, stronger, and take the fight to him. Even though I'm the champion, I'm always taking the fight to my opponents.
I definitely look forward to the trilogy match. And yeah, another thing is, what is the key to your longevity?
Key to longevity is just know when to train and when not to train. You know, the last time I've done any mixed martial arts training is Thanksgiving. So the last time I've been punched in the face has been by about, you know, 2 months. And I think that's probably what, you know, helps with my longevity and just my mental capacity being in mixed martial arts. I've been doing it since I was 18 years old. And I think sometimes taking these long breaks from combat prior to me training in November, I didn't spar from August to November. So that's a huge time away from mixed martial arts, which I think is warranted when you've been doing it as long as I have.
Most definitely. And so with that being said, good luck in your trilogy match. And thank you so much for your insight.
Thank you.
Cheers, Jeff. Our next question comes from Kyle Segal from the Going Live Network. Go ahead, Kyle.
Hey, Demetrious, love watching you fight every single time. With your last match with Adrian, I mean, we always knew your striking was on that different level, but did that just give you that extra level of confidence? I mean, you've been doing it so long, but I mean, just to see you outclass him the way he is, and he's a really good striker.
Yeah, I think my confidence came from when I fought Rodtang. Rodtang is probably one of the best strikers in the world, the heaviest hitter under ONE Championship's banner. And I think me fighting him kind of gave me back my confidence that, hey, I can stand and bang. And then obviously going back to the game plan and really trusting my coach's game plan for that fight against Adriano.
No, I definitely agree. And so if you beat Adriano again and it's in a dominant fashion, what's next for the Johnson legacy?
I think after that, I'll be probably facing Khaled Akhmatov, who I believe is the number one contender in the flyweight division. I mean, he's on a five-fight win streak, and me and him haven't locked horns yet. So I think it'll probably be him. But then after that, we'll see what's next.
Awesome. Thanks for taking the time, Demetrious.
Absolutely.
Next question comes from Stephen Fackman from Violent Money TV. Go ahead, Stephen.
Hi, Demetrious. How you doing, man?
Good, you?
I'm good, thanks. Great to speak to you. First of all, you were kind of the guest of honor at this card here. So how did you find the show?
Oh, it was amazing. Amazing fights from start to finish. The Aung Law fight was amazing. Just the crowd. I think the crowd energy was more amazing than the fight itself, my personal opinion. The Mikey Musumeci fight, Guttermar's resilience, his flexibility in his leg. That was absolutely amazing. And then that final fight against Chingiz versus Superbond. Whew, damn, Chingiz blew the roof off tonight.
Yeah, and you were doing a little bit of commentary as well. How did you find that?
Oh, it was great. You know, I know Mitch and Rich Franklin, we trained together for, you know, in the past. And, you know, those guys are all knowledgeable and I loved it.
Just next, looking ahead to the trilogy, does the fact that you've been in there twice with Adriano already change the mindset or the preparation at all coming into this third one?
No, not at all. Like I was saying earlier, before I was answering the questions, we haven't started training for that fight, you know, regardless. You know, I've only done 2 training sessions of mixed martial arts since my last fight in August. Right now, I'm just focusing on getting better as an athlete with my jiu-jitsu and staying healthy and in shape.
And just one more from me. Looking further forward, obviously, there's a bunch of legalities regarding rule sets when it comes to expanding further around America. But one thing that makes sense, at least to me, is to headline a show in Seattle with you. Is that something that's been talked about at all? And how exciting would it be for you to be able to do that?
Man, that'd be amazing if we can headline, get a ONE Championship come to Seattle. I think the fans in Seattle would absolutely love what ONE Championship brings as a brand and as an event itself with the kickboxing, Muay Thai, and mixed martial arts. I think they would absolutely love it.
Thanks for the time today, Demetrious. Best of luck with the trilogy.
Thank you.
Just wanted to add on, DJ, you mentioned the Mikey Musumeci fight. He's mentioned many times how much he respects you. What's the latest on the proposed grappling match between you guys? I know your dance card's full for the moment, but where do you stand on that one?
Yeah, I'm totally down to grapple Mikey Musumeci. I mean, he's a wizard. I think me and him probably grappled before we even grapple in the circle. I told him, I was like, dude, once you grab my legs, I am tapping because I am not going to play that game and test my flexibility. I've had tears in my LCL and MCL before just fighting in mixed martial arts because my knees are pretty tight. So yeah, I'm totally down to do that, but I'm going to tap extremely fast. I don't have the resilience as that Gujumar did with my knees.
We have a question coming in via text from Andrew Mack of MMA Island, who asks, after this upcoming fight, three out of your last four will have been against Adriano. Will you be excited to fight fresh blood after this is all said?
Absolutely. I think fighting fresh blood is always good. You know, I think it doesn't matter who I fight because I'm always going to go out there and bring the fight. You know, you look at all my fights in one championship or in my whole entire career, I've always brought the fight. You know, when I fight Denny Kindad, Yuya Wakamatsu, Tatsumi Tawada, Adriano, Rodtang, doesn't matter who I fight, it's always going to be exciting. So I know the fans are looking forward to this trilogy fight because, you know, we had 1-1, but regardless, after fighting Adriano, we won't fight for a fourth time. And we'll get some fresh blood and get the fans what they want.
Striking, grappling, MMA, gaming, and rocking the mic tonight, DJ. Excellent stuff. Always good to see you. Thanks a lot. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are joined by the one and only Aung Lan Sang. Aung Lan, fantastic performance. So dominant this win from you. How far away do you think you are now from a world title challenge again?
I mean, I've been the most dominant champion. So, I mean, I feel like two finishes, two fights. I should be, but it's up to Chatri, you know, it doesn't. I have one run in me and I need to make the most of it. So it's really up to Chatri and the one team. But I'm ready, man. I'm ready whenever you guys want. I know there's a card in Denver. That would be cool. And you know, Myanmar fans will show up any city in the world. We have, you know, like 60 million Burmese in the world. So they're going to show up no matter which city it is.
Beautiful work. We go across to our first media question now, which comes from Vince Richards of Sports Keeda. Go ahead, Vince.
Hey, Aung, great win for you. Yeah, first off, such a dominant performance for you today. Could you tell us the knockout sequence you did? And you look concerned when you finally beat Gilbert earlier today.
I wasn't concerned, but I heard, you know, him verbally saying like kind of stop, you know, like that. So I was looking up to the ref, you know, make sure he's okay. But you know, it's a combat sport. This is what we do. It's our job. It's in our job title. We got to keep going until the ref steps in, you know? So, I mean, that was my only concern.
Yeah, just a second question for me. Could you tell us how much of a confidence booster this is for you? Because you knocked out Gilberto in the first round.
I don't know. You know, it's not really up to me. I just know that whenever I fight, I put on a show for the fans because first of all, I'm an MMA fan as well. And I want to make it exciting for the fans to watch. And I have no regards for my body. I'm willing to, you know, put on a great show for the fans.
All right. Thanks so much, Aung, and congratulations again.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from Abdullah of Verdict MMA. Abdullah, please go ahead with your question.
Hey, Aung. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Doesn't get much better than that.
Thank you, Abdullah. Especially with the bonus. So you're right.
Oh, yeah. You said you've got one run left in you. So I've got a couple of quick fire questions kind of regarding that. What's the biggest goal that you have achieved so far?
I'm not sure. I would say winning a world title for somebody that's from, you know, Myanmar, from a small village from Myanmar. I think that would equate to the biggest achievement. Like I'm not super talented. I'm not physically like gifted. You know, if you look at my attributes, it's like I have a hard head, you know, a hard hand, but I'm not like, I'm not super athlete. I'm not super long, you know, but I work and I grind and I work hard. And I try to make up for those with my, you know, with hard work and just putting my head down and working. I guess the biggest achievement would be for somebody from a small village in Myanmar to be able to capture a world title in a big organization like ONE Championship.
You're telling the truth about the hard work part, but I think you're cutting yourself short, Aung. What's the biggest goal that you haven't achieved yet?
I guess winning my world title back. You know, it's one of those things, you know, it's like when you're defending, it's a different mindset. When you're conquering, it's a different mindset. I feel like I'm in that conquering mindset right now. I want to conquer back my world title. I think that that's going to be, you know, the big achievement, because the person on top usually falls, and it's usually hard for them to climb back up, you know, and I want to be able to climb back up, whatever it takes.
Awesome. And the last one for me, what's sort of your proudest accomplishment? You know, maybe the hardest thing that you had to do that you did and that you're proud of during your career.
Of course, winning the world title is, you know, one of the hardest things. But, you know, for me, it's like family, you know, being good with God. That's important. And just being a good team player and a good teammate. That to me is very important, and being a good friend. So like you know, all those achievement amounts to nothing if you are if you're not a good father, if you're not a good husband, if you're not a good friend, you know. So they don't amount to anything if you're always taking and taking, you know. So for me, it's like giving back is very important too.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I love the answers. Congratulations.
Thanks, Abdullah. We do ask, due to time constraints, now that the media limit to two questions maximum, as we go across to Jeffrey Hu from Kung Fu Kingdom.
Hello, Aung La.
Hi, Jeffrey. It's been a while, right?
So,
yeah, stop interviewing. First of all, I lost my belt, huh?
Congratulations.
Just kidding. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. So first of all, congratulations on your win.
Thank you.
Yeah, so you talked about, like, say, for your next matchup, you're just pretty much going to go with whoever Chatri or like the matchmakers match you up with. Are you going to like entertain like any sort of like fight at light heavyweight?
No, I'm going back down to middleweight. I look too bulky. Like I look kind of chunky at even at this catch weight, you know. I'm naturally a middleweight, so I'm just going to stay at middleweight, stay in my lane. If you have too much territory to defend, it's hard. For me, I just want to focus on my middleweight.
Okay. Also, lastly, how soon do you think you could actually go for another title shot at next middleweight?
Month. I could do it next month.
Okay, great. Congratulations and
thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, Jeffrey.
It's bright and early over in the UK. Good morning to Aaron East of MMA UK News. Go ahead, Aaron.
Thank you for taking my question, mate.
Thank you, mate.
Anytime. The crowd were definitely with you, and your skill set was most certainly with you. How did it feel to put on such a show for your home fans, as well as certainly getting it done in the first round? That must have meant a lot to you as well.
For sure. We always want to put on a show. We always want to, you know, make our people proud. So, of course, it means a lot, you know. Yeah, for sure, it means a lot. I mean, it's hard to describe it. It still feels like a little bit unreal right now. But I mean, we worked very hard for this one. My training partners, you know, they helped me out a lot. George Tukas from England is here as well. My trainer Henry Hoof is here as well. So we worked very hard for this. All week we've been very focused.
Definitely showed. Congratulations once again, and I look forward to you achieving another title in the middleweight division.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cheers, Aaron. Next up for our last question, we go across to Kyle Segal of the Going Live Network.
Hey, Aung. Love to see what you just did again. You know, you mentioned the States in Denver. You have thousands of fans in the States. How does Aung go out? You know, do you go out on your shoulder? Like, how do you want to go out?
I want to go on my shield. I want to be carried away in my shield.
Great. And is that like with a title fight or?
It's when the time is up, the time is up, you know, it's not really up to us. I want to keep, you know, putting on shows for the fan and keep progressing as a mixed martial artist. You know, like when you stop growing, when you stop evolving, it's when the world passed by you. So I really feel like I can, you know, I still got what it takes. You know, I still got what it takes. And when I do go, I want to be on my terms. You know, I want to make sure I do everything right. And you know, it doesn't really depend on me. It's in God's hand. I can't tell you when I'm gonna go and how I'm gonna go, but whenever I step in, I'm willing to die. So.
I love the answer. And real quick, so every time we interview, you're so well-spoken. Do you think there's a career after your MMA career in terms of like broadcasting and things like that?
It's really up to the promotion, you know. I might be well-spoken now, but if I can't come up with, you know, nice catchphrases like, I don't know, good night, Irene, or something like that, I don't know. It's really up to them.
We got your answer. Sounds like a yes. Awesome, Aung. Love your career, man. Have a great rest of your night.
Thank you so much, brother. Thank you so much.
Another beautiful highlight on the amazing resume tonight, Aung. Congratulations. Thanks for joining us. Your one debut match ended in a loss to Enrico Kiel, and now you're the champ. How did that loss inspire you?
Thank you, everyone. Support me. You know, guys, my first fight and debut fight in one championship with Enrico Kiel. You know, before this, I know I don't have focus 100% to my mental, you know. I have 100% to my training. Every day I train, but I know mental 100%. Before this, I have many another plans. I have many another. I go to business. I have in other places, you know. But after I lose, after I say and talk about tournament with my coach, Coach Sammy, Chingiz, you're one of the best kickboxers in the planet, you know. But now maybe you don't have focus, your main mental, you lose second fight. You know, please focus 100% and trust me and I trust you and we go to up and we win this tournament. Yes, we will do this. And after this, we fight with Superbone. You know, guys, 1 year, 9 months, maybe 2 years, I focus 100%. Every day I train. My mental only focus to the fight my opponent, only fight. Before I focused to City Chai final fight. Now I focus to the Super Bowl. You know, I said before, I don't mainly talk about fight. I talk about my mental. My mental ready 100%. I prepare every time. For me, no problem who my opponent. I prepare 100%. My mental ready 100%. I win all fighters, inshallah.
Onward we go to a question from Verdict MMA's Abdullah. Abdullah, please go ahead with your question.
Assalamu alaikum, Chingiz.
Wa alaikum assalam.
You had a very long amateur career with over 200 fights. Do you think this is something that should be normal with young fighters today? And how much of your success do you think is because of it?
Thank you to the question. Yes, I have a long amateur career. I have 5-time world champion in Muay Thai World Championship, IFMA, WMC, and other, you know. Yes, I have many promotory fights. But for me, before, maybe I fight 5-10 fights 1 month. It's normal, you know. My coach say, prepare, go fight, prepare, go fight. We have more 200, maybe 250 I have fight. I lose only 3 fights in promotory, you know. I fight before kickboxing, MMA together, you know. But it's normal. I say maybe who start career young, you know, kids, maybe you make it good career to the promoter, trust your coach, and you go to up, and after you have his big, you know, big, I don't know what to say, good technical to the amateur, you have many fights to amateur, and after you go to professional, you change your style and everything okay. You know, this is good for the young fighters. This is good. Promotory career, this is good.
Inshallah. When everything is done and you're long gone, what is one thing everybody should know about you? The first thing that should come to mind when people hear the name Chingiz Allazov?
You know, guys, trust your heart. Trust your coach, trust your team, and trust your game plan. Every day I say, God help me, please. I wake up every day, I go to train. I like this, you know. Don't have days I say, I go to sleep, I don't like training. You know? I focus 100% and my mental 100% focus. I like every day train and I teach every day, you know. You up to up every day and after your future, you know. Guys, I say, young fighters, only focus your training, focus your, trust your trust your life, you know, and trust your heart. And you go to every day, wake up and go to training. And save your technique, and you go up.
Jazakallahu khair, Chingiz. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Abdullah. Next up is Vince Richards from Sports Kida.
Hi, Chingiz. Congratulations on the win.
Hello. Thank you.
You called out Gideon Ursel during your post-fight interview with Mitch Chilson. But there's another striker that you could potentially fight. Tawan Chai, the Muay Thai champion. Would you like to fight him for the Muay Thai belt?
I have many questions. Chingiz, maybe you like fight to Muay Thai. You know, guys, 11 years, I know fight to Muay Thai. Before, all my fights, Muay Thai. Promotory, I have maybe 85% only to fight to Muay Thai. I like Muay Thai. I like elbow. I like knee. I like clinch, you know. We make this. My team, I start my career only Muay Thai, no kickboxing. After K1 go up and I start to training, or no, start change a little bit my style. I training only to the K1, fight only to the K1. But for me, this is another style, real another style. Timing to Muay Thai and timing to kickboxing for me another. Maybe Tawan Chai like come to my way, fight with me in kickboxing, no problem, welcome. I say, I like this, this is welcome. I say it before, welcome to Bangkok, you know. No. You know, guys, but I am going to Muay Thai, this is another situation. I don't like, maybe I know focus 100% the style. I don't like go to fight in other style, you know. But we have many fights Muay Thai, but no, 11 years I know fight Muay Thai. I talk with coach, you know, maybe we like this, but no, maybe I say only kickboxing now. We focus only 100%. I say maybe fight 77 kilo. Yes, I have 77 kilo really. Maybe up a little bit, 78, 79, but everything this weight, you know. I start my training 2 times one day, I lose my weight all time 74, 75, no more, you know. But we already fight 77, maybe kickboxing, Ersal. I like this fight. But you know, in my division have many fighters. I say before, City Chai, one of the best kickboxer in the world, you know, really. Before he pound for pound kickboxing, you know, a kickboxer. I say, for me, Sitcha better to Grigorian, better to Peterson, better to Superborn. I say before, really. This is another style, you know, Sitcha and Superborn, another fighter. But I have big respect to Sitcha. I have big respect to Superborn. But now in my division, have is, I don't know, maybe Sitcha fight with Grigorian, and after who win, fight with me. Maybe before who say Peterson fight, maybe with Grigorian. No problem, guys. I wait who win fight with me. I like this fight. I focus 100%. For me, no problem who my opponent. But I like to take one more belt. Maybe. But Muay Thai now, I don't have plan about Muay Thai.
All right. Thanks so much, Chingiz, and congratulations again.
Thank you. Thank you.
We go across now to Kyle Segal from the Going Live Network.
Chingiz, what an awesome performance. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I remember interviewing you right before the start of this tournament, and it seemed like a light switch. And then all of a sudden, you face Sitichai, you dominate him, and now it just sounds like all your work just went through this. And that's why, you know, Superbond, who people thought was unbeatable, you knock him out in the second round. When do you think that light kind of switched on for you?
You know, first final fight with Sitichai. I fight with him 9 years ago. Yes, 9 years ago. This is rematch. I lose extra round, you know, after extra round. But before fight with Sitichai, I say one more. I focus 100%. My mental is ready, you know. But guys, real, me and my coach, my team, we trust game plan. We trust me, you know, and I trust my heart. And we training every day, and I go to fight. And first round, I see, really, I make this. We will do this, you know. I'm 2 times more to him. I 2 times speed to him, you know. But I have real one secret, you know, guys. I work now, maybe, with CGI, I work maybe 50% real, no 100%. And Superbowl, same. Maybe we work 100%, this is another situation. But my mental little bit, you know, change in the fight. In training, I'm another, you know. In training, I'm more power, more speed, you know. But thank you to Allah. Thank you. God helped me all the time. And I go to make 50%. This is, I need this and I win this first fight and second fight. For me, this guy is too, Sitichai and Superbon, one of the best kickboxers in the planet. Before I say many rankings, Superbon first ranking, I am second, Sitichai number three. In other heavyweight fighters, but now we stayed in first. But guys, maybe I say,
yeah, I mean, you literally just dominated this. You just dominated the top two. So is next, do you think maybe a matchup with Region?
Yeah, I like this. I like this fight, you know, 77 kilo. I don't need test. Test the water, you know, I don't like this. I don't know why, but before fight, 1 kilo, 1 kilo of half, I have lose my weight. My weight 70.3, but I have 69, but I drink many water, but after no check, no good, no good. On the first time I made this, I don't know what happened. I have another plan. I said maybe this, maybe this. 2 months I ready to this test, but I lose, less. No good. I don't like this. Maybe fight 77 kilo. I like this. Guys, maybe I say one to the team Superbone and to the Superbone. I say I have big respect to this guy. You know, he is real, is one of the best kickboxers in the planet. I see many fights to him, you know. I have real big respect. I wish you to him best and speed recovery, you know. And yes, I make knockout. I wish you best recovery. And I wish you all the best to the life, Superbone. Thank you to the fight.
Thank you, Chingiz. I wish you the best of luck, and I'd love to see your success, okay?
Last one, champ. You have a lot of fans in Japan as well. Do you have any message for them?
Yeah, I love Japan. Thank you very much, Japanese people. I know I have many fans, you know. I know they support me. I 2 times stayed in Japan. I like this country, you know. I like Tokyo. I like walking to the Tokyo. Thank you guys to support me. And inshallah, we will see in Tokyo. Arigato.
It was an incredible run for Superbon. I mean, the three victories he had in a row. I mean, you don't get three bigger wins than he had. And then you just went and knocked him out. You got people like Marat Grigorian around. Is this kind of a new golden age for the sport? And do you think you guys will come around again? I know you already fought before.
Guys, you know, yes, he beat everyone, you know. And I see many interviews, he say, I beat Chingiz, Allazov, Krakow, and other. I say one more, I don't like many talks, you know. But I have real respect to Superbon. He have his good game plan to Super City Child. He have good plan to the Grigorian, to the Petrosyan. He have big knockout year to the Petrosyan. Petrosyan, one of the best real kickboxers. Petrosyan, Grigorian, City Child, Superbon, me. This is all five fighters in best of the best kickboxers in the world, pound for pound real, you know. What to say about my division? I say now maybe fight who have fight with me, maybe he fight with City Chai, maybe I don't know. City Chai now is go up, he win fight, and I know this guy is real danger fighter. Who wins City Chai, he fight with me, maybe another situation. But one of see who give me, and no problem. We wait. We now have another plan, you know. Okay, I say 77 kilos, this. But I like now go to state my home 2 months. I don't have celebrated Happy New Year with my family. Before 1 month ago, Happy New Year, I stayed in Manila in Philippines. Before 2 weeks ago on December event 1FC, I stayed in Manila. And after we stayed 1 month, after go to 1 month stayed in Thailand, we changed all only focus to fight. Focus my mental. My coach stayed with me, my brother stayed with me, my team stayed with me. But we know see my family. Now I go to family, rest, focus to my family, my daughter, and stayed with my coach, with my team. And after we talk about the future, it's no problem.
Well, a very happy new year to you and the family. Maximum respect. Congratulations, champ. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, guys.